गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यू आवर थर्ड यूनिट मटेरियल फॉर रिपेयर। द टुडेज टॉपिक इज रेट्रोफिटिंग और स्ट्रेंथनिंग। रेट्रोफिटिंग और स्ट्रेंथनिंग रेफर्स टू अपग्रेडिंग द कैपेसिटी ऑफ अ स्ट्रक्चर ओवर इट्स ओरिजिनल डिजाइन। द डिस्टिंक्शन इन स्ट्रेंथनिंग इज मेड बिटवीन एक्टिव और पैसिव स्ट्रेंथनिंग। इन एक्टिव स्ट्रेंथनिंग द रिपेयर इंगेजेस immediately in sharing the loads as with pre-stress element. Passive strengthening will carry the additional load once the structure is overstressed. As for example, with external steel plates mounting, strengthening of a concrete structure can be achieved in a number of ways. Enlargement, new concrete and reinforcing steel bonded to existing concrete, composite construction, placement of steel plates or structural shapes to add stiffness or load capacity, load transfer by adhesive grout anchors, post-tensioning, pre-stressed reinforced concrete, internal or external systems applied by jacketing, relieves over stress displacement, stress reduction, reduce stress in a structure by cutting new expansion joint, jacketing structure, isolation bearings, removal of portion of structure, internal grouting, pressure inject flowable materials into cracks, voids, polymers, cement based materials, external grouting, pump cement based materials to fit void between structure and soil. Strengthening of structural concrete can be attempted by the following means: replacing poor quality or defective materials by better quality materials, attaching additional load bearing materials, redistribution of the load actions through imposed deformation on the structural system. The new load bearing material will usually be high quality concrete reinforcing steel bars, longitudinal lateral stirrups, etc., thin steel plates and straps, various combination of these. The main problem in strengthening is to achieve compatibility and a continuity in the structural behavior between the original material structures and the new materials or repaired structures. Seismic retrofit of concrete structures. Deficiency in structure requiring seismic retrofit. Design philosophy techniques to enhance the seismic resistance of structures. Advanced techniques for making seismic resistant structures. Seismic retrofitting techniques are required for concrete construction which are vulnerable to damage and failure by seismic forces. In the past 30 years, moderate to severe earthquakes occur around the world every year. Such events lead to damage to the concrete structure as well as failure. Introduction to seismic retrofitting techniques. Earthquake creates great devastation in terms of life, money and failure of the structure. Upgrading of certain building system to make them more resistant to seismic activity is really of more importance. Structures can be earthquake damaged or earthquake vulnerable. Retrofitting proves to be a better economic consideration and immediate shelter to problems rather than replacement of building. Seismic retrofitting of concrete structure continuity. It is the modification of existing structures to make them more resistant to seismic activity, ground motion or soil failure due to earthquakes. The retrofit techniques are also applicable for other natural hazards such as tropical cyclones, tornadoes, and severe wind from thunderstorms. Need for seismic retrofitting. To ensure the safety and security of a building, employees, structure, functionality, machinery, and inventory essential to reduce hazards and losses from non-structural elements predominantly concerned with structural important improvement to reduce seismic hazards. Important buildings must be strengthened whose services are assumed to be essential just after an earthquake, like hospital, etc. Problem faced by structural engineers: lack of standards for retrofitting methods. Effectiveness of each method varies a lot depending upon parameters like type of structures, materials, condition, amount of damaged concrete. Basic concept of retrofitting. The aim is at upgradation of lateral strength of the structure, increase in ductility of the structure, increase in strength and ductility. This is the flow chart of retrofitting technique. Adding new shear wall. Frequently used for retrofitting of non-ductile reinforced concrete frame buildings, the added element can be either cast in place or precast concrete elements. New element preferably be placed at the exterior of the building, non-preferred in the interior of the structure to avoid interior moldings. Adding steel bracing, an effective solution when large openings are required. Potential advantages: due to higher strength and stiffness, opening for natural light can be provided. Amount of work is less since foundation cost may be minimized, and adds much less weight to the existing structure. These are the photographs of retrofitting of shear wall. Providing additional shear wall and additional steel bracing. Jacketing. This is the most popular method for strengthening of building columns. Types of jacketing: steel jacket, reinforced concrete jacket, fiber reinforced polymer composite jacket. Purpose for jacketing: to increase concrete confinement, to increase shear strength, to increase flexural strength. Thank you, student. We will continue this topic on our next lecture. Thank you.